welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as ladolcelisa, and today's episode of Cooking in Quarantine is brought to you by my sister's birthday, because today my sister is having a birthday, and for some reason every year I make her birthday cake. I don't know how this tradition happened, but here we are. And lately I've been making this delicious dessert, and since I made it about 2 weeks ago, I asked my sister what she wanted for her birthday, and she said, I want that pavlova that you made. I made a delicious strawberries and cream pavlova. I love pavlova so much, and I hadn't made one in about a year. And when I made it again, everyone's like, I forgot how good this was. So now we're seriously all craving it. And this is actually, when you think about it, the perfect cake to make, because I hear that a lot of you guys are out of flour and of course yeast, but today we are going to be making a cake without any flour, because this pavlova, the main ingredient is basically sugar and egg whites. So without further ado, I'm going to show you how easy and how delicious it is when you make your own pavlova at home. Guys, the crunchy meringue with a little bit of marshmallowy softness inside, and that delicious fluffy whipped cream that's going to go on top, and then these strawberries, the way I make these strawberries are so good. So I'm so happy to finally share this recipe with all of you. So first things first, when it comes to making a pavlova, basically if you have one of these stand mixers, it just makes your life a lot easier. You can also do this with an electric whisk, but if you really are gonna attempt to do this by hand, I don't think it will necessarily come out, because this needs a lot of whisking time. That would be very difficult. So with this tool, that is very, very important. Now what we are going to be doing is taking 6 egg whites. So you don't need the yolks for this recipe, and actually when you separate the egg whites, you want to be very careful to not get any yolk in here. I have 6 egg whites, which ends up working out to be 3/4 of a cup. I use large egg whites, so keep that in mind. As long as you have 3/4 of a cup, you are good to go. And before we begin to whip the egg whites, it is a good idea to preheat your oven to 275 and to have a baking pan ready with some parchment paper on top. It is good to just be prepared before we get this thing started. So now what I did was I had these egg whites come to room temperature. You do not want to use them when they are cold from the fridge. I of course keep them in the fridge until I'm ready to use them. And then the day of, I take them out of the fridge and I let them come to room temperature for at least like 2 hours on the countertop, and they should be good to go. So what we're going to be doing is adding these egg whites to the stand mixer and then whipping these until they are frothy, and then it is time to start incorporating the other ingredients. So now that the egg whites, as you can see, have become frothy, we are going to be adding our sugar. We need 1.5 cups of white sugar. I'm going to be adding this sugar slowly, about 1/2 cup at a time, as I continue to whip. I am whipping the egg whites on a medium speed. So now that we have all of the sugar inside, you can also scrape the sides of the bowl, and I'm going to increase the speed to about a 6 or a 7 now and let that go until everything becomes nicely incorporated. The sugar should dissolve into the egg white mixture. It should become a fluffy meringue and it should hold stiff peaks before we can move on and add the rest of the ingredients. Okay, so now that we have stiff peaks and the sugar has dissolved nicely, we can then begin adding the last few ingredients. We are going to be adding 1 tablespoon of cornstarch, 1 teaspoon of lemon juice or basically vinegar, anything acidic, and then 1.5 teaspoons or 1/2 tablespoon of vanilla extract. That's optional, but it adds such a delicious flavor to this pavlova. So I like to scrape the bowl down and give this a final quick whip to just incorporate everything, make sure we got all the cornstarch in there, etc. And you can see how nice and stiff these peaks are. They're quite firm. Now we are ready to spoon this mixture onto our baking sheet lined with parchment paper. And we are going to be basically aiming for an 8 to 9 inch round. This is going to be a round cake size. Now the most important part is that you want a dip in the center. So you want the walls to be slightly higher than the center. This helps to make it cook nicely, and you shouldn't get too many cracks in this pavlova. But of course, if you get a few cracks, do not worry. So what I did to hold the parchment paper down is I placed 2 heavy knives on each side. That's just my little trick to keep the parchment paper down. Now with our nice stiff meringue, we are going to lightly spoon the mixture onto the parchment paper while also creating, like I said, that nice 8 to 9 inch round circle with a dip in the middle. You just want to make sure that the walls are sort of evenly sized. You want to make sure that it's not too high on one side and low on the other. So try to get it as even as you can. We're just going to create a dip in the center. So now remove those knives if you use them on the side. You can see this is about 8 or 9 inches and there's a nice dip in the center. It almost looks like a little bird's nest, which would have actually been really cute for Easter, maybe next year. So now I'm going to place this into the oven. It is set to 275 degrees. As soon as I place this in the oven, I'm going to reset it to 250. So just close the door and lower it to 250 degrees and we are going to be cooking this for an hour and a half. As soon as that hour and a half is over, what I do is I lightly open the oven door, let the steam out for a couple minutes, and then I gently close the oven door and leave the pavlova in there for about an hour or two. It just needs to rest in the oven and slowly cool to room temperature. From that point on, you could really do whatever you like. What I like to do is I like to prepare the strawberries because those are going to be sitting in the fridge until I need them. It only takes minutes to prepare and a couple hours to just sit in the fridge and do its thing. So I'm just going to quickly show you how I do that. You can put any fruit or berry of your choice on top of this pavlova, but I love the way I make these macerated strawberries. They are so good. It almost becomes syrupy. And what you need is about 2 containers or so of strawberries. And what I'm going to be doing is cutting the stems off and then quartering the strawberry. If the strawberries are a bit bigger, you can do a little bit more than a quarter. You can cut them into about 6 pieces or so, but generally these seem to be pretty much the same size. So just cut off the top and quarter them and place them into this clean bowl. And of course, be using clean hands, guys. I don't think I even need to be saying that anymore. I think with the climate that we're in right now, we are all being super clean, maybe more clean than ever. I know that my hands are so dry from constantly washing them all the time. So just keep doing what we're doing and we're going to have a nice bowl of strawberries. Okay, so with the strawberries all cut, guys, you don't have to discard these tops. If these are organic strawberries, you can throw these into a smoothie for an added boost of delicious flavor. But now I have this big, beautiful bowl of strawberries here ready to go. I don't usually necessarily measure this recipe. I usually do everything by eye. So I'm going to roughly measure and then I'll taste and then I'll see if it needs a little more of anything. But so far I have 1/3 cup of sugar. I'm just using golden yellow sugar. You can of course use white sugar or brown sugar, but this is nicely packed. We're just going to add that right to the strawberries and give that sugar a mix to incorporate. We are also going to be adding a slightly little extra boost of flavor here. Now, of course, if you're making this for kids and you do not want to add alcohol, feel free to just add about 1 tablespoon or so of vanilla extract or any extract that you like, really. I like to add flavor to this by using alcohol. I have this delicious vanilla liqueur, so I'm going to be using about 1 tablespoon of that. Wow, there's literally 1 tablespoon exactly left. And then for a little bit more of a stronger adult flavor, it's Jen's 33rd birthday after all, guys. She's my older sister, so keep that in mind. I'm still quite young. We're going to be adding 1 tablespoon of liqueur. Any liqueur of your choice would be good. Rum. In this case, I'm actually adding some cognac. I don't really like to have this plain because when I was sick, my boyfriend kept making me have some shots of cognac and it was just so gross. So 1 tablespoon of cognac right to here. It's going to add a nice, sweet, delicious taste with the sugar, so it's going to be very delicious. So all in all, we have 1/3 cup of that light brown sugar, and we have 2 tablespoons of a liqueur, the cognac, and this nice Galliano vanilla. Oh, this actually smells so delicious. The only way that I really enjoy having alcohol is honestly in food, so in like baked goods or some nice wine and a pasta recipe. But this makes these strawberries so delicious. I'm actually going to try one just to make sure that it's nicely sweetened and flavored. Mmm. That vanilla and that cognac is such a delicious mix with these strawberries. I can't even tell you guys. So these strawberries are ready to go. I do not need any more sugar or any more additions to this. I'm going to cover this with plastic wrap and I'm going to place it in the fridge until I need it. This comes together nicely in about 3 hours or so. You can do this even overnight. It's going to be creating its own syrupy juice at the bottom. This is going in the fridge to do its thing. So I will see you guys back here to make the whipped cream and then we are going to decorate and then hopefully I'll be able to sneak a bite on camera. The first thing we need to make the whipped cream is heavy whipping cream. This is 35% cream. This is 473 milliliters, which is exactly 2 cups of heavy cream. So I'm pouring that right into my stand mixer. And right to the whipping cream before we get started, I'm going to be adding just a quarter cup of sugar. This is plain white caster sugar. And to that, I have just a quarter teaspoon of vanilla extract, but by all means, you can skip this step if you'd like. And now we are just going to whip this to incorporate, I would say on a medium to high speed, so maybe like a level 5. Whip this until you see some nice peaks. You don't want them to be too stiff, but again, you don't want them to be too soft either. So now that we have the whipped cream ready to go, we have these delicious macerated strawberries and their juices ready to go. And we have this beautiful pavlova out of the oven ready to be decorated. What I'm going to be doing is spooning on the whipped cream, topping it with the strawberries, giving it a little dash of powdered sugar, and the cake is finished. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this delicious pavlova recipe. As you can see, it is so easy to make, and it's just a few ingredients required that you hopefully can find in your local grocery store. And I will have this exact recipe on my blog post at ladolcelisa.com, so feel free to check it out there. I will link it in the description box down below. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching me make one of my favorite desserts, pavlova, and I'll see you guys, of course, again in my next video. Bye guys, happy baking and happy birthday to my sister. Okay guys, I literally had to sneak away to have a bite. Wow, I always say wow when I eat one of my recipes, but this is so delicious. This is truly one of the best pavlovas you can make, and I love the combination of those strawberries and that cream. The creaminess of the whipped cream and the crunch of the pavlova with the marshmallowy interior. It is so good. I really hope you guys do give this recipe a try. I had to sneak away to have a bite just so you can see what I think about this, but of course, it's one of my favorite desserts. Pavlova, guys, you have to give this a try.